Hello, I'm Morgan Allison, Application Engineer for Tektronix. Today I'm going to demonstrate the Python environment I use to write remote instrument control scripts using VESA and raw socket communication. I also use this environment to do other work in Python, so this setup is appropriate for other workflows as well. All download links used in the video are in the description below. I'm using a PC that is brand new for the purposes of this video. It's running Windows 10 Enterprise, but functionality should be the same with any other flavor of Windows 10. As for Python distributions, I use Miniconda, which includes Python and an incredibly handy package and environment management tool called Conda. I will be using Python 3.6. Do not use Python 2.7, which is a legacy language and is no longer under active development. While this is installing, let's talk about why I use Python for remote instrument control. First and foremost, Python is free and open source, which provides an enormous support base, accountability for core developers, and the ability for users to both inspect and improve its code base. One installation note here. Make sure to select Add Anaconda to the System Path Environment variable. I can't tell you how often I've had problems because I forgot to add something to the path. The Python Package Index, or PyPI, hosts over 100,000 Python packages that extend Python's basic functionality and makes it very easy to set up a Python environment to suit your needs. Python is also cross-platform, meaning it supports Windows, macOS, and Linux. Python is very easy to learn, and its syntax and structure is very human and intuitive. Sometimes it feels like you're writing pseudocode that actually runs. Its primary competitors in the instrument control space are MATLAB and LabVIEW, both of which require the purchase of yearly licenses for the base environment and additional licenses to do additional software development. Python has no such limitation and can be installed and configured very easily. I have yet to encounter a task in either MATLAB or LabVIEW that I cannot accomplish with Python, but I run into the opposite situation often. Did I mention Python is free? Now that Miniconda is finished installing, let's install the required Python packages for remote instrument control. Go ahead and open up command prompt. We'll be using both pip and conda to install our Python packages. To install PyVESA with pip, just type pip install PyVESA and hit enter. Pip is a package management system that is built into Python directly. Conda is similar to pip, but it includes virtual environment management and other advanced features as well. It installs packages from pre-compiled binaries rather than source code like pip, which can help with compatibility issues. To install matplotlib with conda, just type conda install matplotlib and hit enter. Conda will figure out package specifications and prompt you for install permission. Hit enter and you're off to the races. Let's test this out briefly by importing packages we installed. Open a command prompt again, type Python, and hit enter to start the Python REPL. Import PyVESA, matplotlib, and numpy for good measure. We don't run into any errors, so it looks like our packages are installed correctly. Now that Python is all ready to go, let's talk about my IDE. I use Sublime Text because it is lightweight and highly configurable, and it provides many features included in full Python IDEs with only a fraction of the resources required. It does require a license, but you can evaluate the software with its full feature set for free. Sublime Text is also very much like Python in that there are many external modules that can be added to it very easily. While Sublime Text is installing, let's talk about how to set it up as a Python IDE. Sublime has a package control tool, much like Python's pip, and we'll use it now. To use package control, go to Tools, Install Package Control, and it will then give you a pop-up window indicating that it's finished. Then open the command palette using Tools, Command Palette, and type Package Control Install Package, and hit Enter when it pops up. Then type Anaconda in the toolbar and hit Enter when it pops up. There will be another indicator when it's finished installing. One of the great things about the Sublime ecosystem in general, and the Anaconda package in particular, is the high level of customization that's possible. To make changes, open up your user settings file using Preferences, Package Settings, Anaconda, Settings-User. When customizing Sublime packages, I also like to have the default settings for that package open, since it lists all the available settings and gives a small description of what each one does. There are a ton of options, so I'll just go through a few that I prefer to change. Auto-formatting True automatically formats Python scripts using PEP8 upon save where possible. This is mostly for white space structure and comes in really handy. Auto-format Ignore is directly related to this last setting, and I've told Anaconda to ignore E501, which is the maximum line length rule, when auto-formatting. I want to have control over how I manage long lines since I'm almost always writing one on purpose. In addition to auto-formatting, Anaconda also has a Linter, which highlights PEP8 violations and gives you a description of each one. PEP8 Ignore lets you pick which standards the Linter ignores. I have chosen E501, the maximum line length, for the same reason I mentioned before. By default, the Linter uses an obnoxious box to highlight the line where the formatting violation occurs. I prefer to have a slightly less intrusive reminder, so I set Anaconda Linter Mark Style to None. Setting Suppress Word Completions and Suppress Explicit Completions to True disables Sublime's built-in word completion features and lets Anaconda's features take over. Keep in mind that these are my own personal preferences, and feel free to experiment with your own settings. To test out these features, I'll open a script I wrote a while back without thinking too hard about formatting. The white dots in the left gutter indicate where there is a PEP8 violation, and if you click on the offending line, a description of the problem shows up in the bottom status bar. This one tells me I have multiple imports on a single line. If I go down a few pages, I see a bunch of these blank line contains white space errors. There's also a logical comparison and white space surrounding arithmetic operator violations. Now notice what happens when I save. All the white space violations are taken care of, and I'm left with only a couple problems that I can fix myself fairly easily. Using Python or any other programming language for instrument control requires a Visa backend. I'm using Tech Visa for the purposes of this example. I also have an MSO 70,000 series oscilloscope connected to my computer via Ethernet as a TCP/IP instrument. I can launch Tech Visa's Open Choice Instrument Manager and go to Properties for this instrument to get the Visa address. Now that we have our Python environment all set up and our oscilloscope connected, let's test the whole thing out. I'll be using a script from my GitHub repository that contains instrument control examples as a test. I will need to change the Visa address to match the address of my scope. Then I can run the script in Sublime Text using Control-B or Tools Build. As you can see, everything is in working order, and we've transferred a waveform plot from the scope to my PC. I've only just scratched the surface of what's possible with Python and instrument control in this video. For more information and examples, go ahead and check out the links in the video description below.